Right, let's have a look at step acquisitions then. The idea is let's say in year one, you buy 40%, so therefore it's not a subsidiary yet. And in year two, you buy an extra 30%, so that's when it becomes a subsidiary. That becomes the year of acquisition. Now, let's say it cost us $100 to buy 40% in year one, and it cost us $90 to buy 30% in year two. That means we've spent $190. However, the year of acquisition is year two, and therefore it's year two where we work out goodwill. So let's do the goodwill working in year two. And as you know, it's the fair value of consideration compared to NCI and the fair value of net assets acquired. Okay, we don't have to worry about the other two, they're just as normal. It's this figure here. It's the fair value of consideration. Now, we have paid 190, but that's not actually the fair value. That is just what we've paid. So the fair value, the examiner would have to tell you. Now, the fair value of the consideration needs to be in the year of acquisition. So what was the fair value of 30% in year two? Well, it was obviously 90, because that was paid. But what was the fair value of 40% in year two? I don't know. I don't know what the fair value of 40% is in year two. I only know what it was in year one. So the examiner will tell you, in the exam, it will say something like the fair value of the original equity holding, which is basically what he's saying is the original 40%. So is, let's say, 120. So the fair value of consideration in year two is 120, the fair value of 40% in year two, plus 90, the fair value of 30% in year two. So you want the fair value of the two added together. So what would that be? That'd be 210, wouldn't it? Okay. Now, so we would actually take, from here, we would actually take 120 agreed instead of taking 100. All right. So what you also have to do, the extra 20, i.e. 120 compared to 100, also goes to H's retained earnings, because H has made a gain. H's gain on the original 40%. They bought it for 100 and it's now worth 120. So you put that extra 20 to retained earnings. So there's the two things to remember. Number one, you put the fair value of the of both amounts in the year of acquisition, and then the extra from the original one needs to go to H's retained earnings. As always, best done by trying questions, which is what we're going to go and do now.